Hello everyone, this is Shafiq from Knowledge Byte channel. Today we are going to see yet another new episode on VSDC video editor. So already I have discussed lot of features, lot of video editing options in our previous three episodes. So as per a few users request, I thought of to share you a few more pro features which is available in VSDC video editor. So before that, I just request everyone, if you like my channel, don't forget to subscribe. Okay, so coming back to the point, so once again, if you want to start any new project, you should go to new project, give a name to this project and click finish. Now let us insert any video. So for that you should go to add video option, and then whichever the video you want, you can insert that. Now you can see here, if you click OK, the video will be inserted as usual. Now there are few tweaks which you can do while editing video. Imagine now, for example, I have already recorded a video. Now this is a video which already has audio in it, so when I play in the background, the audio will also be played. Okay, now I don't want this audio, I want some other audio to be inserted in this video. For example, imagine already in this video an audio is present, but just give a thought that this audio is not actually proper or is not actually syncing with the video which you have inserted. Now what you have decided, okay, I don't want this music or any audio, I want to replace this video, I mean the audio which is present in the video, with some other audio. Okay, so like this, if you want to do, first what you have to do is you have to click this video in the timeline, then here this is called properties window. In properties window, there is one option below. When you drag down, there is an option below, split to video and audio. So please keep that in mind. So this is for splitting the audio which is already present in a video. So when I click this option, so what will happen, another layer will be created where the audio which was already present in the video will be separated. Now whatever you want to tweak with that same audio also you can do. If you want to split and cut few parts, and you want to insert some other audio, means that also you can do. That is very simple, just by clicking this layer. Okay, if you want to split the first few minutes of this audio, means you have to just click split option, and now this audio will be splitted. And if you want to remove this part alone also, you can remove that. And you can adjust this audio according to your need. This is one thing. That is, already with that existing audio, you want to make any changes, means you can do. That is one option. Another option is, you want to completely delete that audio, means you just have to press delete button. So now this video will not have any audio. This is just a video now, without any audio. Now if you want to add some other audio, you have to go to again add sound option, and whichever the audio file you have, you can click on that and click OK. So a new audio file will be added, so wherever you want to place, you can place it, and when you play, that will be played in the background. Okay, so this is another option where you can remove an audio which is already existing in the video, and you can add some other audio to it. It's very easy, right? So this is what is called tweaking with the audio. There are a lot more features available when it comes to video effects. Now you can see, when I click this video layer, here in the tab, video effects is already there. You can access this here also, or if you want to access from here also, you can right click and you can access video effects. This is nothing but there are some styles which is available here. So if you want this video to appear in some style, like black and white style or some sort of different elegant designs, like in Instagram and all you used to do for photos, right? You apply some filters to the photo so that it can look somewhat attractive. The same way for video also, if you want to make it look somewhat attractive, means you can actually select from any one of these, so that what will happen, your video will look something like this. Okay, so this, if you want to apply, you can easily apply in Quick Styles. Then you have another option called adjustments. Here lot of options are there. Everything is actually related to the color which is present in that video. Sometimes when you shoot any video, it may look like somewhat dull in color, maybe because of lack of lights or because of the quality of the camera. So that and all you can actually fix with the help of these options. So if you click auto levels according to that video, okay, however or whichever is the best matching color, if you want it to fix, you can fix it. You can see automatically according to its need, okay, the adjustment has been done, so the video will look something like a better one than previous one. Okay, the same way adjustments, you can give auto contrast, so according to its need, the better contrast option which is applicable for this video, that will be applied. The same way auto gamma, like this brightness, contrast and hue saturation is nothing but changing the color. So you can adjust the colors over here. You can pick any color and you can adjust it. So depending upon that, you can see some adjustment is happening in the video. So if you want to do all these changes in color aspects so that your video may appear somewhat better, somewhat in a different style, means you can apply all these video effects. Then you have something called filter. So sometimes if you want it to appear in somewhat blurry image, or you want to sharpen the video, pixelize, lot of things are available. So those things you can apply. It is something similar to what you do in Photoshop. Okay, so like for example, if I click motion blur, somewhat you can see the whole video will be appearing in the form of a blur format. Okay, and the blur angles, the blur distances, all that you can fix here. And in blur also, different type of blurs are there. So if you click radial blur, it will be like a round shaped one, and you have to adjust the blur angles here. So for example, maybe 10 degree something, means so your video will appear somewhat blurry. So it's actually not for the whole part of the video. You might have seen, right, when changing from one video to another video, this kind of effect will be applied. So it will spin and it will change. So like that, if you want to apply, then only we will use this blur option. And here in timeline, you have the flexibility to adjust. So from which part to which part of that video, this blur effect should be applied. So you should select that option and then click OK. Or you want to apply in time in the form of zoom blur, means so when you play the video, you can see zoom blur will be applied. So that's what is actually it is meant for. Okay, so it is not meant for applying the blur throughout the video. So it will be like only few part of that video will be applied in the form of the blur. Okay, so you can see from here to here. So before that timeline, the video will be perfect. So once it reaches that blur area, then only the video will actually shift. So that you can give some extension to it. Okay, so up to wherever you want, you can just blur it and keep. Then we have some other options like transforms. So this will be very much useful when you're having any video. So transform means like you might have seen in many videos, or like when it is being played, slowly the video will zoom and come to the front, or slowly it will flip, or it will change, it will tilt. All this, you might have seen these kind of effects when one video changes to another video. So that these transformations will be applied only at the end of one video. So imagine if you have placed two videos in this timeline. So after one video ends and before the another video starts, you can apply this transformation options. So you can click zoom here and click OK. So you don't have to apply till the end, you can apply only to a specific region. Okay, sorry. So you can apply to a specific region. Now when you start playing the video, zoom will be applied. So you have to actually keep the zoom levels here. So it before by default it will be 100, so when you keep 150 here, so once it reaches to that position, so that 150 level of zoom will be applied. So it will change from 100 to 150. Okay, so this type of zoom you won't do in all part of the video. So if you want to give any specific message, then only will do. And you can do some adjustment here, x level, y level. X level, y level is nothing but from x axis how many degree you want to move that video, and y axis how many degree you want to move that video and zoom it, that you can do. So all these are some of the basic filter effects or video effects which you can apply when you are working with the video. There are a lot more video effects options are there, like transparency, special effects. So it is something like if you want the video some sort of fiery like appearance to happen, so that kind of visual effects you can apply. So it is something like a fire is burning outside the video, then you have some other options as well, like for example fade in option, fade out option. This usually we will apply the beginning of the video. So fade in when you give before the start of the video, so it will appear like a fade in one. So you might have noticed that thing. The same way fade out at the end of the video, it will slowly disappear. So automatically it will apply at the end of the video. So you can see after the video ends, slowly it will disappear. So all these are some of the transparency effects which you can apply. You can give any borders to the video, you can remove some background also in the video. So a lot of things are available there which you can do with the video. And transitions, it is nothing but when one video changes to another video, some sort of animation like wiping, push. So if you apply something, so that will be applied. So you can see at the end of the video, that particular transition will be applied. Okay, so all these are a few tweaks which you can do when you work in VSDC video editor. Okay, so today I'll just wind up today's session. I hope you guys would have enjoyed this episode, and if you like this video, please don't forget to like our channel and also subscribe it. So till then, all of you take care, stay safe. Okay, bye bye, see you in the next episode. Thank you.